What is up, YouTube? This is Rob from RP Model Railroads. Before I jump into this video, I just want to say thank you very much to all of my subscribers for helping me reach 500 subscribers on YouTube. I truly appreciate all of your comments, support, likes, and insights throughout this past year, and I hope to make 2022 even more awesome, especially with the Ephrata Valley Railroad 4x8 layout project that I'm working on. And that is exactly what this video is about. Showing you guys what I've done to the layout so far in the past few weeks and talking a little bit more about what I plan to accomplish. So, stay tuned. First things first, and probably the biggest accomplishment that I've done on this layout so far since nailing down all the track and ballasting all of it, has been scenery, and that is in terms of trees. So I was able to save all of the trees, or at least the woodland scenics lichen trees off of the original Ephrata Valley Railroad 4x4 layout. Some of them, like I mentioned previously, didn't look so good because when I made them, I used hot glue, and so some hot glue was sticking out in some places, as well as, you know, hot glue strings, etc. So I took my time when removing these trees and using some leftover Woodland Scenics autumn lichen. I glued some more on in the places where some of the hot glue was sticking through. I used Gorilla Glue and super glue, a combination of the two in different places, to kind of fill the trees a little bit more. I also used some scissors to trim them so that all the lichen wasn't hanging all over the place to make the trees look more realistic. And then I glued them down to the layout with super glue so they won't move. On the previous layout, I glued them with hot glue and it held for quite some time, but they were quite easy to remove. So, and in a few cases, I actually had to re-hot glue a few of them down. So, with super glue, I'm confident that these trees will stay exactly where I want them to be. So I glued trees on both sides of the tracks here on the rear left corner of the layout to kind of simulate the tracks through the trees scene. That was probably one of my favorites on the original 4x4 layout. So I kind of redid that scene here and I think it turned out pretty awesome. And then since I had some more space up against the blank blue sky backdrop, I glued more autumn trees to basically line the whole side of the tracks all the way down to the end of the backdrop so that it makes for a nice area to take photos and videos of trains on this side of the layout. I also glued some autumn trees on the right side of the layout. And here they are. So these trees I had to modify a little bit more. I had to cut the bases flat on one end so that when I glued them down, they would basically be flat up against the backdrop. And this was because I really don't have that much space in between the outer track there versus to the backdrop. So I wanted to make sure that the trees would still look good, but the trains wouldn't be hitting them every time they'd pass by. And I was able to accomplish that. And on the ground, I spread some Woodland Scenics green turf and also some orange turf to look like fallen leaves. I didn't do that on the opposite side. I let the green carpeting fabric, whatever you want to call it, that I put down on the actual tabletop show through, and I think the illusion still looks pretty good. So overall, I'm satisfied with how I was able to save all of these autumn trees from the layout. And of course, in terms of the actual layout itself, I still have a lot more to do, a lot more particularly in the town scene and scenery in general. And of course, speaking about the original 4x4 layout, it is now no longer with me. I basically dismantled it. I took all the track off and removed everything that I could possibly save and put it into some Ziploc bags, and I hope to repurpose a lot of that stuff, including some more trees, onto this layout. But I'm really glad with what I was able to do so far in terms of scenery and just how well it turned out. So I hope you guys enjoyed this update video. Thank you very much for watching.